Welcome to the Vicky tutorial video series. My name is Dale Rota from BioStat Global Consulting, and the purpose of this video is to give a brief overview of the Vaccination Coverage Quality Indicators, or VICI. VICI is a set of STATA programs that you can use to conduct standard analyses of data from vaccination coverage surveys. It analyzes data from three types of surveys: those that document routine immunization, those that document coverage in vaccination campaigns, also known as supplementary immunization activities, and those that document the proportion of newborns who were protected at birth from neonatal tetanus. These survey types are known informally in the VICI documentation as RI, SIA, and TT surveys, respectively. VICI produces standard tables and figures as well as data sets of results, and VICI analyses are meant to be consistent with recent guidance from the World Health Organization as described in the 2015 draft and the forthcoming 2017 finalized reference manual on vaccination coverage cluster surveys. The vision or the goal that motivates VICI is to have a set of flexible programs for survey analysis where the programs are separated from the details of any particular survey. This way, analysts do not need to start from nothing with each new survey, and they do not run the risk of failing to update some details from their last project if they reuse code for a future project. We have defined formats for survey data sets and variables and metadata, and the user provides those in ways that we will describe in detail in this video series. And then they analyze them with a generic library of VICI programs. Because we're not scrambling to develop the programs under the tight deadlines of a single survey, the code can be tested thoroughly so that we can be confident that it gives correct results. And finally, we share the code freely using practices that we hope will make it user-friendly. We track changes and enhancements over time. We have the capability to roll back to earlier versions if desired. We conduct tests using small simulated data sets where we know what the analysis results should be. We document the formats for inputs and how to conduct and interpret analyses. And finally, we share the code so that others can look at it, modify it if they wish, or add to it. Another part of the vision is to be very clear about the indicators or the outcomes that VICI calculates. We've written descriptions and specifications to make it clear which respondents are included in or excluded from the calculation, which indicators are weighted and how that works. In the case of proportions or rates, how is the denominator defined? How is the numerator defined? And how specifically is the outcome calculated? We hope that the documentation is clear enough for others who understand what VICI is doing, and even to be able to reproduce results outside of VICI or using another package if they wish. The last aspect of the VICI vision that we'll describe today is flexibility. Some coverage surveys provide results for a single stratum, maybe a nation or a province or a district. Other surveys provide results for several strata, and other surveys provide results for nested strata. As indicated here, we might be conducting a survey in the upper province and the lower province of this nation named Sassafrippi, and we might want to calculate results for the upper province, the lower province, and for the nation combined. Or in some cases, we might want to see results for each district within each province within the nation. So we might want to see national results, provincial results, and district level results. And VICI is flexible. It provides flexibility for up to three levels of nested administrative, or sometimes we think of them as geographic, strata. And optionally, it also provides flexibility to stratify the results within each geographic stratum. So you can have coverage results by sex, by urban versus rural, by household wealth quintile, or other demographic strata. So it's flexible concerning both the geographic and the demographic strata of the survey design. VICI is designed to analyze data from cluster surveys that provide results for one or more strata and use a probability sample. Relevant data sources could include USAID, DHS surveys, UNICEF MIX surveys, and WHO's Expanded Program on Immunization surveys designed using the recent guidance. Vicky could also be used to analyze data from older surveys or those with simpler designs, although this may require some strong assumptions. Vicky can be used to analyze data from the earlier EPI 30x7 cluster surveys. It could be used to analyze data from a cluster lot quality assurance sampling survey, or even from a classic LQAS that uses a simple random sample. If you have questions about whether Vicky can legitimately analyze data from your survey, don't hesitate to post a question on the forum in the Vicky users group on the TechNet 21 website. You'll see a link to that users group at the end of this video. At the time we're making this video, in June of 2017, Vicky includes 21 indicators, 18 for routine immunization, 1 for neonatal tetanus, and 4 for post-campaign surveys, as well as 3 for different aspects of describing the survey dataset, and 2 for calculating whether coverage differences are statistically significant or not. In a single analysis, you can select the subset of indicators that's relevant for you. There are really 2 types of people who should know about Vicky. There are those who commission survey data analyses, and there are those who conduct the analyses. If you are a program manager or someone who uses survey results for action, then we want you to understand the sorts of analyses you can request, and we want you to understand how to interpret Vicky output. Some of the videos in this series of tutorials are aimed at you. And if you're someone who will conduct the Vicky analyses, if your daily work already involves analyzing data with statistical software, if you're comfortable with using and manipulating data sets and variables, then many of the videos in this series are aimed at you. If you are someone who might commission Vicky analyses, then feel free to post any questions that you might have on the TechNet 21 Vicky users group. If you are a WHO employee in a country office or a regional office, contact Dr. Carolina Donovaro at WHO headquarters to discuss your survey. And if you will be planning a coverage survey in the future, you could consider designing that survey and its questionnaire and its database of responses to be compatible with Vicky from the very start, and we can help you do that. If you are someone who might conduct Vicky analyses, check the links below this movie viewer to learn how to obtain Vicky and get started. Watch more of these tutorials and download the associated files so you can follow along and replicate our results. Thank you for watching.